This is one of the stupidest things I ever done. Following a coast road in the desert against the wind. I have a hard time to stay on the road and to keep moving.
Good morning, YouTube.
So we are at the map again. We did Lima, Pisco, Ica, Palapa, Nazca, and today we're going to Lomas because I have to go to Arequipa. Between here there's not an awful lot of hotels, and the hotels I found so far, they don't have Wi-Fi or they have extremely slow Wi-Fi.
As you can see, I am packed. It's 7 o'clock. I woke up at 5:30. My bike is all packed, my stuff is packed, so let's get it downstairs.
Standing here in the wasteland, it's 9:45, it's about 37 degrees, and I already finished 2 water bottles, so that goes quick, but it's absolute lovely riding here. People are friendly, many people are put the thumbs up and waving. So there you have it, there's my face again. But lucky for you I can make it short, because by now you should get bored to see my face over and over and hear me talking over and over. Words cannot describe how thirsty I am and how hot I am. It's a bit harsh climate here as well. I cycled for 3 or 3.5 hours now, and I drink over 2 liters of water. It's a bit hot. Yeah, the wind is quite dry and it's quite hot. It's a very dry climate here, so that makes you mouth very dry. That makes you very thirsty. Small break, but I found a little bit of shade here. That's good. I do have a little concern right now, because the wind is coming up, and if you look on that side, there's a few clouds coming as well. I don't expect rain because it's way too dry here to fall rain. But I'm not sure, there may be another sandstorm is coming. right here, where the wind is coming from the back. So you don't hear, you don't see any wind. But when we stand in the wind, it's already getting quite strong. And yeah, so we're halfway now. We have to do another 50 or 55 kilometers. So yeah, if the wind is crazy strong, that will be a bit of effort. But that's not the biggest problem. The biggest problem is I only have one bottle of water. Because this one is almost empty and then I have one left. So another 45 kilometers to Waddenstorp. It's a bit far when there's a bit of storm going on. Coming, I have to go off the road because the road is too small for trucks to pass me when I'm driving on the road. So I have to drive on these loose stones. Really annoying. Today we make a mistake, eh? Big mistake. Not enough water. So we are riding towards the ocean, supposedly there's a small city or so. And I saw back down on the road two signs that there's a hotel. I looked before on the Google Maps, on the Maps.me and on the iOverlander. And there's two hotels on the, with information. One on Booking is 35 euros. One with the Facebook page is 30 euros. Then there's two hotels without price information, but they have Facebook. And then supposedly there's another two hotels, but I cannot find any information on them. So the most expensive one, the 35 euros one, what's on Booking. And I saw a sign down the road that says 60 sol. That's about 15 or 16 euros. So I might check that out. Comparing to Asia, it's still very expensive. But yeah, comparing to Peru, where the normal price is around 50, it's not too crazy, especially not if you see where we are. So today, all the way from Nazca till about 6 kilometers back, there was nothing in between, no shops, nothing. And there was just 2-3 shops now. I buy some extra water and stuff. And now up front you see a car coming. That's the first car I see in about 8 kilometers. And now you see the city upcoming. Looks a bit like a big city. But this is the only road to there. So if there's no cars driving, it might be a bit of a ghost town. I'm not even sure the hotel is open. But yeah, we will find out. So I made it to my hotel, thumbs up, and there's only one thing left to do. Chill out. No, actually there's no time for it. The best thing of all is this. So we woke up at 5:30, it's now around 6.
and prepare myself some breakfast. I make a coffee. I have some old bread from yesterday, so that's pretty okay. But I want to show you the view.
The strong wind of yesterday is back, so we're fighting against the wind again. So this is how I take a break. I find a little bit of shade. I removed one of my panniers. It's only close inside, so I can sit on top of it. So today we're battling against the wind. We're going out downhill. Yet we only do 8 kilometers an hour. And we're in full fighting mode. So you can imagine how hard the uphills are. Just brutal. One of the stupidest things I ever done, following a coast road in the desert against the wind. I have a hard time to stay on the road and to keep moving. We're just slightly going uphill, nothing too crazy, but I'm going so slow that I'm almost falling. This is absolute brutal. We're doing such a slow progress. It's now 10:30. We started at 7. We did only 20 kilometers. I think something like 600 something kilometers to Arequipa. With this speed, we might be there next year. This is full craziness. Why did I do this to myself?
So we're in a hotel today. So today I break a new record. It's a bit of a sad moment actually. I rode 45 kilometers today in 7.5 hours. So that's like pew! So I'm pretty wasted right now. It's just, this wind is mental. I hope the wind slows down because it's still 450 kilometers to Arequipa. The last stretch to Arequipa, when we go from the ocean up, we might have the wind in the back. But yeah, there we do a lot of climbing. I think Arequipa is around 1800 meters. There you have it, guys. Another video. I hope you like it. If you like it, put the thumbs up. Leave a comment down below. Don't forget to subscribe, and I see you in the next video.